Good morning again. Technical difficulties has been the theme of the day if you're just tuning in and haven't been sitting here watching the technical difficulties. I probably just need to simplify what's running on my computer. Next Monday during my admin time, I'm gonna strip it clean of everything I don't use and like start fresh, and hopefully things will be less crashy. I am not an IT professional and have no idea how to fix this stuff. Hey, the top of the window's cut off. I'm gonna fix that. I can fix that. That is a skill I have. This one. Ha ha! Fantastic. So hopefully, today is the last day that we play some Dwarf Fortress. Until I'm ready to record the tutorial. And hopefully, the recording of the tutorial is more accessible to people who want to watch. Because the recording of the tutorial should, I'll be explaining everything as we go, and hopefully that's more accessible to people that don't know their way around Dwarf Fortress. We are going to try to pump lava all over the world, because I am upset. Hi, Dana. Yeah, Steve, I just... Without an end in sight to the tech difficulties, it's just... It's not worth broadcasting technical... Nobody wants to watch technical... I shouldn't say nobody. Maybe somebody really enjoys watching me struggle with getting my internet to connect properly to people across the world. Maybe that's, like, super engaging, and I don't know what I'm talking about. But I feel like that's not the sort of content that I want to be broadcasting. And an hour is plenty. So we've given up. Refium, yeah, we spent yesterday doing some Barbie time for a few soldiers who wanted to update to the new cosmetics. It's funny, like yesterday I told people that there are enough new cosmetic options that it's worth the price of the DLC. And then as I like slept on it and my brain thought about it a little bit more and I've crystallized some opinions, the options that they gave are super weird. They're super weird. Like, they fit a theme that I don't think of as the theme of XCOM. Right? Like, the whole anarchy thing is really weird. Like it's XCOM, not Borderlands. Yeah, the stuff's all like spikes and feathers and leather and midriff showing and tight pants. It's not like we're a paramilitary organization. It's like we're a band and you just don't understand our music. It's very weird. Which, I mean, is fine if you... Like, if you like that and if that's the XCOM experience you want, it's a lot of cool customization options. At probably a really, like, really reasonable price. It's just bizarre. All my water's drying out. How am I gonna charge this with enough water for it to function? we have a new problem. We can probably, with proper floodgate and door control, pump water in from the river. Sadly, no, Arachnator. We fought technical difficulties for 45 minutes, and I needed to get some kind of actual stream started. So we had to give up for today. We're going to find some time off stream to work out all the issues, and we'll get back to Divinity on Wednesday, hopefully. I'm gonna connect up these little pools while they're frozen, and then when they thaw out, they should all flow down into my little water system. I wonder if I connect to this weird little lake that's been built here. I wonder if I connect to that, if that's enough water to charge this thing up. We're gonna have to wait all the way till spring to get this thing to go, because we have to have the water thawed out to boot up the water wheels. It didn't freeze, it dried up. Refium. I think that other water's on the surface. Hi, Mage Kron. I see you. Hi, Neck. Are you dwarfing today, too? People are dying in trees again. Yeah, I doubt that's enough water up top to fill this up, so we're gonna have to divert water from the river. Which means we're gonna have to build more floodgates. Which are X's, of course. X's for floodgate. Because alphabets. No access to floodgate. Oh, because this door's locked. Okay, we're gonna remove it and replace it with a floodgate. Hi, Combi Chris. Am I using therapist or am I being totally hardcore? I am using therapist. I'm using it really poorly. But I don't know if therapist or hardcore are the choices. Like, I think the choices are therapist or masochist. Like, I don't know if I would call that hardcore. I don't feel like therapist is like, man, if you resort to using therapist, you're just not good at video games. Because, I mean, are you really gonna use this interface to make sure all your dwarves have jobs? Is that 45 minutes of your time every hour of gameplay? The difference between hardcore? Or is that just like some kind of weird psychological disorder? Because really, like, trying to organize your dwarves with this much information visible is, I don't know. I don't know if I would call that hardcore at all. Like, that's just a person who really, really likes to imagine spreadsheets in their mind and not actually use a spreadsheet, or enjoys pain and suffering. The only reason you play DF is because you like pain? That's fair, Knack. Except, do I have to like this flavor of pain to be hardcore? Because I feel like if you want to brag that you play Dwarf Forge without therapist, I mean, you guys know that I resist modding my games. You know that I don't do a lot of, like, I'm not all about changing the design of my games away from what, how they were designed. You know, like, I like default settings. I mean, I play without a graphics pack, for crying out loud. But I feel like Dwarf Therapist is just necessary. Like, I don't know. I mean, I played for a long time without therapist because I didn't know therapist was an option. So maybe in that sense I'm hardcore. But I don't feel like Dwarf Fortress has the same sort of culture around it as like XCOM. XCOM definitely has a no save scum culture, where like you're not really playing XCOM if you ever don't play on Iron Man. If you ever load a save, you're not playing an authentic experience. I don't think Dwarf Fortress has that, especially not around mods and therapist. Are we starting the lava apocalypse yet? Yeah, we have to get some water to charge up our reactor. Which is going to require us to do a little bit of prep work. But we're hoping to flood the world in the next 2 hours. That is the hope. Let's make floodgates here and here. Is Nibble being... Nibble disconnected while I was disconnecting all of my internets. There you go, MageCon. Nibble's back. This fortress doesn't look the same with that water all over the floor. I know, Durkin, I fixed it. Yay! Yay! I mean, there's still some residual water, and there's definitely a lot of mud. That, you know, we can look to the mud as the remnants of those moments in the fortress. Uptime has always worked by me telling you in the past, but recently, because my bot has the capacity for uptime, I think Lizzie programmed the command in. Thank you. Why am I fixing all these bedrooms? Do I think we're gonna be here long enough for this to matter? It hasn't mattered thus far. I don't know why I'm working on this. I should work on the parts that matter. We need to repair the pump stack, and we need to put all the doors in all the way down the pump access tunnel. Come clean, I'm gonna be here forever. I really hope today's the last day of my refresher course before the tutorial. I really do. That is an honest desire. People be dying off in this fortress. I can't even be bothered to care. Alright, so this floor got its floor built, and it's definitely connected to this one. So my miners should be able to get down here and dig out those stairs. Yeah, Kami Chris, this fortress was never meant to be like running efficiently. That wasn't ever the desire of my heart. It was just supposed to be a quick and dirty, let's pump magma to the surface of the planet and blow everything up. And it ended up having a lot more dirty than it had quick. Like, it was never supposed to grow to this many dwarves, just this project has taken way too long. Serious suggestion for the video tutorial, slave myself to the wiki newbie guide and go through it step by step. That's probably where I'll start, Nack. I mean, I'm gonna write out a script and plan out the tutorial pretty thoroughly. And I probably will start with the newbie guide, just to not reinvent the wheel. We have extracted quite a bit of fun out of the game, for sure. So, it's my understanding that doors will stand up to magma no matter what they're made of, as long as you never open them. And we're really hoping that's true, because it was a lot quicker to make these doors out of wood than stone. Let's record a macro. Door. Is my camera flickering? Are you guys seeing, like, am I... Camera, why are you flickering? That macro didn't work. It's like seriously wigging out right now, right? I have no idea what's causing that, and it terrifies me. This Monday, I'm not going to get anything done. All I'm going to do all of Monday is, like, troubleshoot my computer. Did I upgrade to Windows 10? Was it via update or a fresh install? I think it was via update. which terrifies me, because if I have to do a fresh install to fix these issues, I'm going to lose everything. Like, I'm going to lose all my OBS settings, I'm going to lose all my installed games. Like, that is going to be a 16-hour project to recover from. Which is not great. It's not what I want. Tell me how I would use a small SSD boot drive, Dana. Yeah, I'd probably have to reinstall everything anyway, right? So, it's gonna be pretty brutal. But it's probably what I should do. I mean, my machine running stably is a pretty important part of my chosen profession, and I should probably just figure out how to make that work. And not be afraid of the time investment. Do I know my Windows 10 product key? No. Is there a place I can find it? We're only on floor 71. We're out of doors! I am out of doors. Alright. Oh, we have a bunch more doors being built. Okay, good. Thanks for the link, MageCraft. Doors were unable to complete granite door. Why? Oh, because our furnace operator is throwing a tantrum. Great. Yeah, Flutterdash, but it seems like a good idea to have a backup plan, right? So I'm gonna be careful to have a backup plan. What can I do while I wait for them to build doors? I could link up these floodgates. I could build more beds. People seem to need beds. I always use the wrong key. There we go. That's where I want my walls. Dig a control room for these floodgates where we can see the floodgates while we toggle the levers. Do I have mechanisms? I'm just gonna make a bunch more. I think I have a lot, but no harm in making a bunch more mechanisms. Planters are out of seeds isn't a huge problem. Okay. Do we have coffins coming? We do. They're just way down the list. Where are my miners? Sleeping? Constructing buildings? No. Don't construct buildings. Mine things. There's miasma in the halls. That's like the least of our concerns. So many things so much worse than that. Like that dead dwarf up there in the water channel, you know. Is all this death being caused by a vampire? No, this death is caused by goblin sieges, killed a few people. Lack of good hospitals killed some people. Dwarves like to climb trees when they're scared. And then they can't climb back down, so I chopped the trees out front from under them to get the dwarves out of the trees, and they did not survive the fall, a lot of them. I don't have any coffins yet. Let's put the coffins at the top of the list. We still have corpses that need buried. You're surprised the spiral hasn't happened yet? I am too! I feel like we're really close to spiral time. And we just need to hold out until we can flood the world with magma before we spiral. We've had a lot of people just die. out in the trees. But seriously, what are my miners doing? Because they're not mining. Why are they storing items in stockpiles and not mining? Do you not have equipment? We have, like, hundreds of picks everywhere. I built, like, 30 copper picks. Do you not have your job turned on? That's on. Alright, people should be mining. And yet they are not. Oh, there he goes. Diggy diggy hole. My dwarves are the world's desire to purge itself of impurities. Yeah. Yes, they are. This has been a death cult since day one. It's a surprisingly populous death cult. We have 150 citizens. All they eat is plump helmets as part of their death cult. The giant Kias are back. That means we're gonna have a whole bunch more dwarves dying in the trees. It's time to kill giant Kias. Get to work, kids. Now they'll do these in order, right? So if I have a pull right after they're done linking, and then I add the task to link this one, that should work. See if that works. Bardock, imagine just how horrible the other four are supposed to be if migrants come here. Now when they come here, it says a migrant has arrived despite the danger. So our PR department hasn't been doing their job. workaround to the tree problem is to have a meeting room designated. I do, Knack. Yeah. I have a meeting room designated. It's kind of small for 150 dwarves, but it exists. I think what's happening is combat is chasing them up trees. All these giant Kias. Anybody who's outside when the giant Kias come runs up a tree to hide. I do think that Arachnator's got the right of it. Cutting down all the trees preemptively will prevent your dwarves from climbing the trees and starving to death. With the wonderful side benefit of making the stupid filthy elves angry at you, which is definitely what you want, is stupid angry elves. Embark somewhere without trees. You need some source of wood. Or you're gonna have a bad time. Because you can't make beds without wood. Elves have awesome exotic animals you can tame to fight for you. Yeah. Yeah, I guess there is some benefit to having the elves bring the trade caravans. Hey, Nevernight. Smooth this whole thing. I don't know why I'm building these guys a bedroom. We're just here to kill the world. But I'm tempted to smooth it all so that those walls don't look atrocious. It's happening. Get engraved. I don't know if I even have anyone who does engraving. There it is. Okay. You just put engraving on a woodworker so they engrave whenever you don't need any wood. Yeah, I mean, at the beginning, when you only have a few dwarves, that's a good way to run it efficiently. But as I'm not really putting in the effort to run this fortress efficiently, I'm just gonna hope that somebody has the engraving skill enabled by default, and will go do that work. I mean, I could probably just check in therapist. I guess. Set some engravers. Read the dwarves. Sorted by, let's see, stone detailing. We have two people with the labor enabled. Let's enable a few more. Now there are four. Out of 150. Check the drink status occasionally. Suspended. Don't suspend that. Uh-oh. Woodworkers slipped into depression. Too depressed to eat. How's the stack looking? Wait, is that a door? What? Oh, it's wooden as opposed to rock. They look really different. I've never built wooden doors before. Blocked access to those. Let's go ahead and build the walls down here. Great. Doors are in. Doors are in. Doors, doors, doors. This one's missing a door. Okay, that's as far down as the doors go. How far down does the floor go before I keep running into stairs? Okay, there's stairs. Why? The stairs are designated to be removed, I assume. I'm gonna redesignate all these stairs. To be removed. Okay. I'm going to lock and forbid all the doors so I don't get dwarves deciding to play in the magma. We have to build the pumps first before I can forbid all those doors. Those doors are there, so we have access to build the pumps. Oh, we have a few coffins now. That's nice. We should go back up and build the coffins. Oh, my engravers are engraving. Great, it begins. It's gonna look so pretty for no reason. Why is it suspended? Stop suspending that task. I really need that linked. The worst part of all these Kias is I can't see why they're suspending this task. Those miners are pretty eager to do these. Are they doing my stairs? If they don't do the stairs, this thing's lost. Come on, miners. Have you mined out my stairs?
No.
Alright, which floor has the last stair? Why aren't they mining the stair? That's just a pipe section, right? Okay. It's not construction, is it? Why aren't they fixing these stairs? Can they not get down here? I mean, they got to here, they built the floor. Those stairs appear to be connected. I cannot diagnose why they can't get to this one. If I tell them to dig over here, will they do that? Wow, we smelted all the hematite. That's amazing. Not gonna do that either. What if I tell them to dig this one? Will they do that? Oh, my military finished killing all the Kias, or the Kias left. So that's nice. I wonder if any of them died. No, still 5 and 7. They're not busy digging elsewhere. No, they're like pasturing animals and no job in storing items in stockpiles. They're not... They're definitely not off digging somewhere else. Where did I cut off access? Okay, that stair exists. It's a weird color, but it exists. The floor's waiting for construction, though. Oh, that stair's waiting for construction. This is the problem. Why won't they build it? So if I tell them to dig here, they'll immediately queue that up. Yeah. Okay, so why aren't they building this stair? Can't they build stairways down? Like, can't they hang a stairway from the stairway above? Should be able to get down to all these jobs. Right? That guy's building the floor. Oh, there's no access down from here. We need to dig a downstairs in the corner. Now they can get down. We can build the rest of these floors. Get the pump stack repaired. It's happening. That's a good question, Glaive Master. Yeah, I mean, we should look into why that stair didn't get built, right? Is this... it's not a construction, because it would be flashing like the floor. So it's a dug stair. I have no idea why they wouldn't build the stair underneath it. It's really bizarre. Thank you. only have like 30 more of these to do. So there's suddenly, like, the list here is suddenly shorter than the list was when we were building these floors before, which means that there's no access to materials from down here, which is probably a bad sign. Somewhere my staircase is broken. We need to find it. I think dwarves are getting down here okay. Like a good embark site. Freezing, no trees, scarce vegetation, terrifying surroundings. Yeah, it seems decent, except the thing you're missing, is an aquifer. Knack. Because, you know, if you can get down to the stone there, your life's gonna be okay. If you had an aquifer in those clay or soil levels, before you could get to any stone, that's the only thing that could make that embark site any better, is just the inability to access stone would be super helpful. How deep is that? Ones should dry up. Perfect. Why is that super helpful? I was being facetious, the Mafia. I mean, if you look at the link that Knack linked, like, that is almost the worst possible embark site. Almost. And I was just trying to make it just slightly worse. Okay. Good. Alright, so now we need to wait for the doors, which are in progress. We could make some coffins while we wait. Thank you. I wonder if everyone's buried yet. This place does have some history of death. Used for burial, no pets. Okay. A tomb is only needed... Yeah, so, like, if you go to your noble screen... noble screen? They will require... So, like, this guy's a noble, and he requires an actual tomb. But that's the only time. I mean, it would make... It makes dwarves happy to own a tomb. But they don't need them unless they're a noble. I mean, you can see this guy is getting all of the things he needs, for sure. For sure. But if you're, you know, if you're trying to run a successful fort where people don't get upset and punch each other in the face and then die horribly, yeah. They will auto-collect dead people. Yep, as soon as you assign them... as soon as you assign the coffins as burial sites, the dwarves will go out and collect any bodies that need burying, and they will bury them. You had the easiest Avenger defense ever in XCOM 2, the Enhas? Was it as easy as mine when we dominated the Andromedon? He walked out and two-shotted the beacon, and everybody else just kind of hung back playing cards by the Avenger lift. Get that last one? There was one more that was... Wow, they've already filled these all up. Like, we just barely made this row, and they are all full. Somebody's gonna need more coffins. Waiting for? We're waiting for doors, right? So we can finish building the pump stack. Oh, we can start assigning the pumps. If the bottom is magma free. That embark also only has salt water? Awesome. Yeah, that's... Maybe you don't want an aquifer. Can aquifers be salt water? If aquifers are only fresh, Maybe an aquifer would make that embark easier. It's almost dried up. Come on, magma. Dry up. I need to start building my pumps. Someone had an Avenger defense where they mind-controlled Andy and activated a sectopod which walked through the beacon. That's fantastic, Glaive Master. Oh my gosh. That's my strategy for my next Avenger defense. Come on, Magma. Evaporate. You can do it. Are you guys stuck? Can you not go back to the surface? Why y'all hanging out down here? The stairs are connected. That should be stairs all the way up. Wait, what's this? Says it's a stair. Oh, that stair's waiting for construction. Disaster. Okay, let's dig stairs around it. Oh wait, that was an upstairs. I wanted an up-down stair in this floor. I want an upstairs here. And a downstairs there. I'll rescue you! I have no idea why they're not constructing the stairs to connect these stairs, but they're not. You should just wall off the surface to get dwarven caravans through the cave layer. That'd be cool, I don't know if they can do that. There you go, kids. You've been reconnected to the surface. Go get some water. Do I have? Oh, a bunch! Alright, record a door macro. Up. Whoops. Oh, I messed it up. Alright, record the door macro again. I did it again. Terrible. No! What are you doing? Macro! That was terrible. I don't know why I drifted like that. I'm out of doors. Okay. Is that open space? Of course it is. Five more magmas need to evaporate. We need a lot more doors. But at least we can start building pumps after just a little bit more evaporation. Those are already resting places. We still haven't caught up with the need for burials. I don't think five more coffins is going to be enough. Need empty bucket? What? I built like 30 buckets. What could my buckets possibly be full of? Ridiculous. Ooh, did this ever get levered? It did. So now if I pull this, it should switch the floodgates, right? It should basically just trade which channels open here. You should have loaded up on wood. You have 3 wood from the wagon. Knack. So you get 3 beds that your guys can share. It did not work. It closed this one, but it didn't open that one. Oh, I need to store buckets in the hospital storage. Does the hospital even have storage? Beds, tables, traction benches, buckets. They've got 2 buckets. Thank you. I should really set, like, a hotkey for here. Probably already even have one. How do I scroll this? We still have 5 magma down there. It's taking such a long time to evaporate. Hi, Lizzie. Elves are partial to the trees of the forest around your lands. We are loath to spare a single branch to senseless slaughter. We're willing to ask that you cap your tree fells at 100 until we next meet. I will try to return next year as I am able. Okay. We can part with at most 111 trees. That is a lot of trees. I think I'd be hard pressed to cut that many down. Anyway. There's things happening in the world that we don't care about, thank you. Great. Was that a short joke, Elf? He said we don't always see eye to eye and then laughed. I feel like that was a short joke. Can't build anything else until the magma evaporates. We can build doors. I don't have any doors. How goes the march to the end of the world with magma? We're working on it. We've got a lot of... We have to wait for the water to thaw out, and we have to wait for the magma to dry up at the bottom. I have not ever played the Talos Principle, Steve. It's a puzzle game, right? Yeah, Trix, I think if I wanted the hospital to work effectively, we'd want to, like, start soap production. We might want more than 2 buckets. 2 buckets is the default. I didn't change any of those settings. These aren't immediately claimed. Maybe we're done burying everyone. Yay. Maybe we can quit this. The next thing, we just need lots and lots of doors to build the pump stack. We're down to 4. We only need 4 more evaporates. Dead Missing 170, what happened? Many, many things have happened. But this does include, like, all the giant Kias we killed, and the Krundles, and the goblins, and the llamas and stuff, and the chinchillas. Who's been killing chinchillas? Right, so, I mean, it includes non-dwarves in that Dead or Missing list. Alright, I've got to figure out what's wrong with my floodgates. Withdraws from society? Yeah. Taken by mood. What does missing mean? It usually means that they died, but there was no one there to see it. It's typically what it means. You claim my mason's workshop? Rude. I need that for doors. How tall does my pump sack need to be? It's like 180 pumps tall. 170 maybe? It starts on floor negative 162 and goes... Yes, it's like 165 pumps tall. And we've already produced all of the pipes and corkscrews, I think. We might have to build a few more. But we don't have any sand either, Freya, so... They are... These sweet pumps are 100% iron. Okay, mysterious construction started, that's good. What was I checking? I was checking on my floodgates. Oh, so the switches don't work the way I want them to. Can you move a link? Can you take a link out? You just have to deconstruct the thing to remove a link. I wanted it to be a toggle. Can you not set... I thought if I had it set to, like, one side, and then linked the trigger, and then set it the other way, that it would toggle, but I guess it doesn't. Hey, evil chicken. We're gonna keep doing this for about half an hour. And then... we'll be playing some XCOM a little bit later. Okay. Remove building. Build a new lever. Have we been able to flood the world? Not yet, Refium. We're still waiting for, like, we need the spring thaw to get water, and we need this magma to evaporate. I did realize we'll be playing some Factorio soon. Did we link this up? I can't remember if we linked this one or not. Not that one. that one is linked. That's good. Let's pull it again so that it's closed when the water starts flowing. We're down to three. We are down to three. We're almost there. Can almost start building the pumps again. We've got a granite millstone. How useful. How useful. The Faint Funeral is a granite millstone. All craftsmanship is of the highest quality. It's encircled with bands of rectangular granite cabochons. This object menaces with spikes of granite and giant Kia bone. On the item is an image of Scream-dredged the Sylvite figurine of Cattle Roof Gorges in giant Kia leather. Yay, birth. Have I had any Titans visit this fortress? Not yet. This fortress would not be alive if Titans had visited it. Our military is very, very poorly trained. Okay, so we want to pull this one and close that floodgate. Might have to pull it twice. In fact, we should probably pull this one too. My defense is magma. It is once we get it built. Yeah. There we go. Now the doors are configured correctly. And we just need spring to spring. What month is it? It's early spring. We're there. We're almost there. We have half an hour to build all the pumps. Ugh. Come on, magma. Yes! Yes! How did the magma get there? I don't want to talk about it. Is how it got there? No. We accidentally, preemptively activated the pump stack. Oops. And it was designed poorly, and the magma leaked out and destroyed some of the pumps. And then the whole pump stack came crashing down. Because they have to be, like, on top of other pumps to support themselves. So that was kind of bad. And the leaked out magma ended up in this area. And we had to spread it out a little so it could evaporate. Any tips for an XCOM player trying to lose no countries in Classic? XCOM 1? You just always prioritize satellites. Just satellites, satellites, satellites. And that often means workshops, so you have enough engineers to launch more satellites. This one doesn't have any doors. Doors. Doors, 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 doors. Oh, not doors. I'm out of doors. Build doors faster! Buckets full of. Is there a way to see stocks? Can I find buckets in this list? Buckets. What's going on with the buckets? That one's full of ice. Oh, well, there's your problem. Who filled up all the buckets with ice? Disaster. What is this carrot? This is Dwarf Fortress. If you don't install a graphics pack, it looks like this. I prefer this view because I played for a long time without knowing there were graphics packs and got used to this, and now I find the graphics packs more disorienting than not having one. Okay, there's one magma left. This looks like magma, but it's not. It looks like it because there's magma below. We see that one to evaporate. When that one's gone, we can start building the pumps. Gmods or mechs or both? In classic XCOM Chicken, I usually go for mechs as fast as possible. And then Gmods if I have like extra stuff laying around. Gmods are never a priority for me. But, like, I usually try to have a mech... Like, I try to field a mech soldier on the portent mission. Like, that early in the game. I want to have a mech on the ground. Come on, dry up, magma. We are literally, like, watching this pot. I mean, we're not literally watching paint dry, but if you substitute paint for magma, that is what we're doing. Come on, magma, go away. decide to evaporate. Get out of here. Oh, we're about to have water. We should go. Is our water's flowing. Yeah. We can charge up the, we can charge up the magma system now. Or the pump. The reactor. Charge the reactor. Can you accelerate time in Dwarf Fortress? No. Sadly. I mean, if we were running a real fortress, Nairu, there would be plenty of stuff to do, and we wouldn't be sitting around waiting for that magma. Like, we'd be building the bedrooms, and we'd be making sure that our dwarves had a variety of food to eat, and we'd be planning out new farms, and there'd be tons of stuff to do, and we could just go check on that magma occasionally. The problem is that I am being a silly. Here comes the water. I hope there's nobody in the pump area. Portent is the one before that, evil chicken. It's the very first one in that storyline. Charge it up. Spin those water wheels. Did these dump? They did. Those did dump their water into the system. Good. Shut off the flow and let that water settle and look at the levels. Ones and twos still. We want a little deeper than that. Alright, let's turn it back on. I'm gonna be your first mech right on, chicken. I hope I serve you well. I will wear that mech suit with pride. Oh, the pumps are pumping! It's going! It's on. A gremlin! Drive it away? Okay. I will do that. Now, wait, what was I doing? We need to be careful about the water situation. It's on. Power's being produced. Making 1300 power. Do I have a ton of masterpiece enormous iron corkscrews? I probably have a few that are masterpiece. I would guess. How did my perpetual motion machine run out of water? If the water stays at a depth of 2 or greater Rephium, it'll never run out. But my water depth got down to where there were a few parts at 1, and those start to evaporate, and then the water spreads out, and then it evaporates. So we have to charge it up with enough water that the depth is at least 2 everywhere in the system. And then it won't run out. Just gotta get it charged up. I should probably turn on... How do you turn on the... Is it in the INI where you turn on the water depth view? Or can you set it in-game and toggle it back and forth? I don't actually know how to do it. Seven out of seven. Fives and fours. Threes and twos. Threes. There's some ones up there. Hopefully that settles in before we get the pump. Before we get the lever pulled. Alright, 1400 power being produced in that system. Pumps pumping hard. Water flowing. We are online. The magma's still there. Get out of my way, magma! I can't build this pump stack except for from the bottom. Magma, go away! Watched pot never boils. Let's stop watching the pot. Migrants have arrived despite the danger. Thanks, migrants. Welcome. Welcome, friends. Kill the magma disappear by dumping water on it. I don't want to dump water because if it splashes onto the magma sea, then I'll have to clear out obsidian, and I'd rather just wait for it to evaporate. Two snipers or two anything else squad-wise? Vanilla snipers, once they get past the first few ranks, like their first rank, they're terrible. But once they get past the first few ranks, they are absurdly overpowered. Two snipers for sure. I wonder if this is enough power. I'm surprised that it capped out at 1400 and that it needs 797 to run all the mechanisms. We might have to dig another reactor section. Hi, Dark Magician Girl. Go away, magma! I want to start building pumps. I want to start building pumps. How's the water reactor doing? It's working. It's running. I don't know if it's producing enough power to power my entire pump stack. I'm worried that I'm gonna need several more reactors. Which continent bonus did you get? North America or Asia are the ones you should start with. And the preference between those two is a personal preference. I usually used to go North America, but Asia is also quite strong and is a very common choice by other players. Okay, what else do we need to do? We need to build doors. We can build doors while we wait for magma. We also need to lock all the doors. How many more doors are we doing? Probably all of them. Whoa, calm down. I'm out. How many more empty doors? 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17, 19, 21, 23, 25, 27, 29, 31, 33, 35, 37, 39, 41, 43, 5, 7, 9, 51, 3, 5, 7, 9, 61, 3, 5, 7, 9, 81, 3, 5, 7, 9, 91, 3, 5, 7, 9, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 115, 116, 117, 118, 119, 120, 121, 123, 5, 7, 9, 50, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 61, 3, 5, 7, 9, 81, 3, 5, 7, 9, 91, 100, 100, 104. 104. I need 104 more doors. Great. How many are in the manager? 46. Seventy-six. 106. Okay, that should be enough doors. Should be enough doors. Don't apologize for questions, chicken. We love to answer questions here. Trying to build a really friendly community and answering questions is a big part of that and important to me. I appreciate that you're asking. Wooden doors? Yeah, so as long as we don't ever open the doors, Refium, as long as we leave them closed all the time, wooden doors will stand up to the magma just fine. We need to leave this running for a while. Maybe I'll leave it running so it can queue all those doors in the background while we play some XCOM. Just kill the volume. And let all those doors happen. Because that's what we're waiting for. Yeah, wooden doors will stand up to magma surprisingly well. How'd my power go up to 1600? Weird. Keep the music, it'll be good music for XCOM. Let's jam out to this calm guitar while we XCOM things. Alright, sold. We're keeping this music. And I'm going to put this where I can keep an eye on it. And we'll check in occasionally to see if our doors are done. And people would be like, where'd you get this great music? It's so peaceful and calm for my XCOMs. Yeah. Peaceful and calm is what we do. Leaving it running in the background is a great recipe for disaster. Well, we love disasters. Here's the truth. It's going to pause itself occasionally because people will, like, give birth or something. So, you know, we'll be able to check in on it from time to time. Someone died of dehydration, Freya. They're probably in the hospital and can't drink anything but water, and my dwarves are really bad about delivering them water. Or at the top of a tree and stuck, because we love to climb trees and get stuck. That's probably what's going on. Hi, Millen. Yeah, so we just need to wait for doors for a long, long time. And we need to wait for that stupid magma to stupid evaporate. Hurry up and evaporate, stupid magma. I am going to play this fortress until we successfully pump all the magma to the top of the world, Steve. I was hoping we'd get that done today. The magma evaporated! It's gone! We can start the pumps! I mean, we can't start the pumps, but we can start building the pumps. But yeah, as soon as we successfully pump the magmas, we're done. Pump, 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 pump. Pump, 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 pump. See you around, Garrett. Thanks for hanging out today. Let's start the... What do you mean, no access? Okay. Let's record the macro. Pump, 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 pump. Up. Pump, 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 pump. Up. And the recording, play the macro. We can do it. You like how this has accidentally become a demonstration of how DF actually plays while you're trying to do something specific? Yeah! There's like a ton of stupid things to worry about. And we had an awful lot of things happen to us while we were trying to get this construction built. pump to pump. What floor are we on? 106. Any other tips on XCOM? I mean, without a specific question, tip chicken, my basic tip for XCOM for new players is never reveal any Fog of War except for the very first move of your turn. That's like the basic tactical tip. Because that's how you lose tactical missions, is you accidentally see a new pod of aliens on like your third or fourth move, and then you don't have enough moves left to respond to them, and that's where like the spiral starts to go downhill. But yeah, without a more specific question or like an area where you're looking for advice, that's my basic XCOM tip. It is, yeah, I mean, it seems like such a simple thing, Refium, and I still do it wrongly all the time, and then regret it. I need to set up a divert valve for my magma sack so I can flood the caves as well. Yeah, we need... Setting the pumps to be built is not the last step of this. We have a few little nitpicky things to establish before we enable the pump. What about beginning research? I don't remember the vanilla game well enough to give you a research path. But, you know, if you look up, like, the research tree on the wiki and just emphasize getting those mechs early in the early part of the research, you'll be good. What was that sound? I have never heard that sound from this game before. I should move all my dwarves to live with it where all the magma was. It's an infinite supply of magma. We're not going to pump it out. Sounded like Discord. Discord isn't running. What is? Stop making that sound. Something, is it Skype? Quit Skype. Wasn't Skype. That's Discord 100%. Do I have a Discord page in a web browser? I mean, Discord is not running. I'll launch it and reclose it, I guess. Thank you. I'm in Discord on a different PC, MageCon. That, there's no way I'm getting sound from that Discord. We did it. It's built. The stack is planned. Now we just have to wait for doors and, like, the final touches. It was a release. It was minimized in the toolbar. I hate programs that do that. Programs should not minimize themselves to the toolbar. Such a frustrating feature. Like, show up where I look for what programs are active. Don't hide yourself. And then make noise. If you're gonna hide yourself super silently. We need to put walls by the top pump. Yeah, Glaive Master, we will. There's a little bit of finishing touches to be done. We need to put doors down the rest of the pump stack so the magma doesn't leak. We need to put walls around this pump so that it can pump the magma safely without breaking itself. And then we need to make sure that the magma can flow into the caves without stopping the power system and without breaking the pump stack, because we do want to fill literally everything with magma. So there's those finishing touches to be done tomorrow, not tomorrow. Sunday, we'll do those finishing touches and we'll fill the world with magma.
A new subscriber arrives.
And
it fills you with determination.
Right now it's time for XCOM. Malice Reign. Get in here, get a squeeze. Welcome to the Bearded Council, Malice Reign. Thank you for your subscription and your support. Appreciate you. Fill that chat up with cookies. Good work, Refium and Senlicken. Get those cookies rolling. Have I ever tried the Lazy Noob pack for Dwarf Fortress? I think I downloaded it one time, and I looked at it and I was like, the only thing I'm going to use from here is Dwarf Therapist, so meh. I should probably look at it again. But as a person who doesn't like DF Hack and doesn't like the graphics packs, there's the only thing from the Lazy Noob pack that I use is Therapist. And I should probably give it another look. Okay, well, dwarves are going to build pumps for a while. Let's save the game. And we will return and finish building doors. And the catapult. We were going to catapult our entire fortress population off of the planet before they destroy the world. We'll get to that later. Because now it is time for XCOM. Malice Reign, I popped your subscriber cherry. Aw, welcome. Welcome. I'm glad to be your first. I hope I was gentle. Right on. Oh, there's D&D Monday. Yeah. Glad you're enjoying the channel. Absolutely glad. Call music stopped. Danger is coming. Yep. We are going to turn on